advise going inside. Not with your reputation for depravity and general aversion to the law, in all seriousness. Your countenance is quite discernible, and there are certain of my consociates who would take it upon themselves to exercise their right to lethal force were they to encounter you in person. But it's good to cross paths with you again, my friend. After head of security at the Diamond, this isn't exactly what I had in mind, but it's still a long way from a mall cop, right? Let's take a walk. Relax. I'm a cop, but I'm not a cop. This is just where the universe put me right now. I mean, I have my path and you have yours. And quite frankly, I don't give a damn about your antics out there. In fact, we may be able to assist each other. I mean, check this out. You see that misguided individual? How do you think he's gotten away with selling drugs in front of that burger shop very conspicuously for 10 years now? In front of the largest department in the city. He cuts them in.
Effenberger, you copy? Yo, Effenberger.
I copy.
Worst last name ever, dude. I mean, Effen what? Anyway, when you got five, we all need some effing coffee down here on Dick's. And don't forget the effing cream and sugar.
Copy that. Oh, these motherfuckers. Huh? I'm out here getting coffee for cops on the take. And that guy over there is only a modicum of the issue. There's a new cartel running a large-scale cocaine operation out of the Cluckin Bell factory in Palito Bay. And be in no doubt, the cops, they're not only turning a blind eye, they're actively facilitating. If you ask me, the cartel and the cops can both go to hell, preferably on the back of the same bullet. I'm talking about a surgical strike, man. Taking out the whole operation. That's why I came to you. Let's go somewhere a bit more unfrequented. I understand your motivation in these matters. If you raid that factory, anything you find is yours to keep. But this isn't about the drugs for me. This is about these assholes running the biggest protection racket in the state. That's the kind of status quo I cannot abide. As far as my part, I can provide all the intel you need. Records, names, locations. We will need to educate ourselves on the factory, though. Gather materials so you can attack it with style and aptitude.
Ding fucking dong, Officer Effenberger. We're effing falling asleep over here. Get us some effing coffee.
Copy that. I'm on my way. Think about it. If anybody deserves to be fucked with, it's these guys. Can I count you in? Excellent. Now on to the first order of business. Acquire some funds. And fortuitously, we have files on some money laundering operations not far from here. The department allows them to operate for a share of the profits. I suggest we take a more proactive stance. Time to do what you do. I'll call you. Let me take these fucking assholes their coffee.
Get the fuck you at? You're gonna
Based
die.
Based on comms, they do not look pleased something. With you.
We gotta slow them down.
Get in the cover.
Bitch.
Shit, we got a man down. Die, motherfucker.
Fuck!
You're gonna die today, motherfucker!
I'll fucking kill you!
Amounts of cocaine. The factory up in Cluckin Bell those homes. And that's where we come in. I've just marked the local garage on the GPS. Once upon a time, it was an FIB facility, then LSPD for a while. Now it's disused and wonderfully off the rails. A potential way into this place. The cartel are paying off employees of Cluckin Bell to use their factory as a cover. There are a couple things we'll need in order to solidify my current infiltration plan. Let's move.
Site.
Take whatever steps you deem necessary. So, we have some important yet enjoyable decisions to make. On one hand, you need to acquire your preferred weapons and gear. On the other, you need to acquire your getaway vehicle. We'll need to steal both. These can't be traced back to us. Where would you like to start?
Especially if you're there for one of their cars.
weapons and gear can never be traced to us. Just what you need to go up against an adversary with the LSPD in their pocket. We'll need a getaway vehicle with a similar provenance. That's for another day. That should suffice for our purposes. If you want more options, be my guest. When you're ready, just send me a message confirming the equipment you want to use. Got it. Good. I'll arrange for any extras to be stashed in case you change your mind. I appreciate your professionalism. Next up, acquiring a getaway vehicle. We need to take the same precautions we did for the weapons. We steal it from a gang, so the trail leads to them instead of us. Salutations. There are three potential getaway vehicles spread across these locations. Sending surveillance footage of the gangs I found. Check them out. I'm sure you have plenty of vehicles capable of getting you out of Cluckin Bell with all your extremities intact, but we need something that can't be traced to us. I've acquired three suitable options for a getaway car. All of them are sourced from local gangs bribing the LSPD to turn a blind eye to their activities. If the car ends up getting traced, the trail leads back to them, not us. We only need to use one of them for the raid. The choice, as always, is yours. Sounds like they see you. Get ready.
Thank you.
There's a garage close to the factory where the car will be safe.
What miracle did you want me to perform?
Getaway car secured. Well done.
All that's left to do is leave the area inconspicuously.
That your MO is up to you, but there are steps you can take to ensure the element of surprise is on your side. Introducing a little chaos into the cartel supply line is one of them. If you do, they'll assume your arrival on the train is just an unscheduled delivery. And if nothing else, the looks on their faces will be highly amusing.
Patch the information. Sabotage the trucks, find the key card, wipe the CCTV, and get out. That way, the cartel won't see you coming. Now, you can blow up the trucks and do this the old-fashioned way, but the cartel will find out, and trust me, they'll be waiting for you when we hit the factory. I recommend you keep your head down. Even in that getup, they'll still lose their cool if you're spotted wandering into the more sensitive parts of the building.
Hey, go back to where you came from, Holmes!
The hell?
Get to cover!
If those guys know you're here, you gotta take them out. Otherwise, you risk the cartel hearing all about it.
Hey! Get the fuck back! Everybody get back!
Animal. Fucking piece of shit.
Yeah, you're fucking dead!
They got any deposit boxes. Lockers. You can search them for key cards if you got a way to break them open. I admire your dedication to clandestine tactics. It will be a major asset when we hit the factory. Find that key card. Since they don't know you're coming, check this out for some advanced strategy. We're gonna need Cluckin Bell crates big enough for you to hide inside. Yeah, that's right. We're gonna Trojan horse this factory. Look for something we can use. Seize it and bring it back. Pleasure to inform you that we have officially completed all necessary preparations to move forward with the Cluckin Bell operation at your earliest convenience. Let's make this happen.
Chilero. Pues no sé.
Ayúdale.
Oh.
I see you over there. You better get up out of here real soon.
Once you got eyes on the product, don't hold back.
You better...
Let's fucking go!
As a chicken factory. One would assume they'd have more Cluckin Bell staff to keep up appearances, but I underestimated just how bold criminals can be once they have the police in their pocket.
Fucked up my body up!
establish a connection to the computer first. I read up on how to use the hacking device. Unexpectedly fucked once we made it to this point. All you have to do is find where the signal is the strongest. If the device is showing blue, you're headed in the right direction. Red, you're not. Once it's caught the connection, find the next one.
Motherfucker! Fucking idiot! Move in now!
Remember, there are multiple connections. You need to hack each one before you have the code.
Excellent work. Mission accomplished. Now to the vital matter of payment. As I'm sure you can appreciate, there are certain transactions I can't be party to as an officer of the law. But if I've learned anything from my consociates on the LSPD, it's how to look the other way. Now, remember, as far as I'm concerned, you can hit that factory as often as you'd like. As long as you're giving me reasons to keep looking the other way, I'm happy. As you can see from my choice of transportation, my fortunes at the LSPD are also improving. Just got these babies in, fresh off the line. Guess who picked one up? Until next time, let's disassociate. Is in your account, and of course, to congratulate you again on a successful operation. Our efforts to derail the Cluckin Bell cartel's efforts were indeed effective, but it won't be long before they and their corrupt counterparts in the LSPD rebuild their little enterprise. Each and every time we knock them back down, I'll ensure it's worth your while. Effin' murderer.